Now with Senator Legarda, your 5 minutes.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Since this is, I realize, the last hearing, and all of us have sat here for 5 long sessions, apart from the executive sessions, my questions will be very, very brief and direct to the point. And I would just like to ask the heads of the various institutions present here today to just kindly answer this simple, very basic question. Who, therefore, after having heard everyone and everything, would we consider the head, the commander, or the person responsible for Oplan Exodus? First, I would like to hear from the Chief of Staff of the AFP. Then I would go to the other institutions. General Katapang, please.
Madam Chair, Your Honor, really, we cannot pinpoint on the part of the armed forces who is the overall commander of this operation, in as much as there's still a lot of confusion who really initiated the order to launch this. And I would rather have the PNP decide on really who was the one who decided to launch this operation.
General Purisima, would you be able to tell us now, since you told us in open hearing that this was initiated during your term when you were still active as PNP chief and met with the president when you were suspended in January of this year? May we therefore hear from you, who would you consider the head of Oplan Exodus?
Madam Chair, Your Honor, the Philippine National Police, among the powers of the chief PNP, has the delegation of authority to subordinate. May I read the powers of the chief PNP, Your Honor?
You can just put that on record, sir. Thank you for that. Could we just hear from you now, having sat here for 5 sessions, sir, in an executive session, which we don't have to discuss, but just kindly tell us, having known about Oplan Exodus from the beginning and having coordinated in a limited way after the time you were suspended, sir, who would you then consider to be the head of Oplan Exodus?
Your Honor, the responsibility, accountability of the Oplan Exodus rests with me.
Rests on
me, Your Honor, because I have delegated that authority to the Director of SAF. But the planning, the direction, and control of the operation was delegated to PNP SAF. But the accountability rests with me, Your Honor.
Accountability
of that delegation.
Yes, and then you delegated the authority to
Director SAF, Your Honor,
who is General Napenas.
Yes, Your Honor.
Yes, thank you for that. May I hear then from Secretary Gazmin, based on everything that was discussed here, and having seen, of course, from the intel packet, although belatedly after the operations were unsuccessful because of the deaths of the 44, who would then, as a military man, a former military man, would you consider the head of Oplan Exodus?
I would consider the head of the Oplan Exodus, Your Honor, to be Director Purisima. Former Director Purisima, Director General Purisima.
Thank you for that, Secretary Gazmin. How about Secretary Rojas, from where you sit and having heard everything, and by now you, just like Secretary Gazmin, would know all the operations from the time it was an intel project to the time it was implemented as an Oplan. May we know, who do you think in your mind is the head of the Oplan Exodus?
Deputy Director General Purisima, as well as the head of the SAF, who executed the mission, the ground commander, Director Napenas. I wish to add, Madam Chair, Your Honor, that precisely whether it is advice or order, there was an overt attempt or effort to keep this away from the OICPNP and from the SILG.
Thank you for that, Secretary Rojas. General Napenas, I heard the statement of General Purisima stating that while he has the accountability, because he was suspended, he delegated the authority to you, sir. May I know your answer to my very simple and basic question to wrap up things? General Napenas, please.
Yes, ma'am, Madam Chair, Your Honor. The operations of Oplan Exodus, I am the ground commander and I am the one responsible in the carrying out of the operation plan. However, I would like to say this, just like what Director General Purisima said, that he's taking the accountability, although the authority was delegated to me. I just like to point out, Your Honor, that this operation plan Exodus, it all started when the intelligence was given to me, when I was called by Police Director General Purisima sometime in the early part of November at 10 o'clock in the evening on a Sunday. So from there, I took it, my understanding is there is urgency to do the operations, being called there on a Sunday evening at 10 o'clock. So we started working. After we prepared the operation plan, we had it approved by the Chief PNP, Police Director General Purisima then, who was still active. So as he said, that he delegated to me the authority to carry out that operation plan Exodus, but it all emanated when the intelligence packet coming from the Chief PNP himself was given to me, Your Honor.
And again, just to wrap up, my simple and last question to reiterate. In your presence and in the presence of General Purisima, and I believe, was it Colonel or General Mendez? Senior Superintendent Mendez, and one more on January 9. Was there any directive by the President to coordinate with the AFP?
It was a comment, Your Honor, during that meeting that coordination shall be made to the Armed Forces of the Philippines, Your Honor.
Whether a comment or an advice or information or a directive, was it clearly stated by the President?
It was clear, Your Honor, that coordination with the AFP should be undertaken.
And therefore, having the authority been delegated to you after his suspension, shouldn't you have coordinated then from that January 9 directive of the Commander-in-Chief to coordinate with the AFP?
I wish that I could be given that authority, Your Honor, because otherwise I will be bypassing the OIC-PNP, and that's precisely the reason why that statement of General Purisima said that saka mo na sabihan yung dalawa, ako nang bahala kay General Katapang. Without a statement, Your Honor, I could immediately go to the OIC-PNP, who has that line, to coordinate directly with the Chief of Staff Armed Forces of the Philippines, Your Honor.
Again, just to wrap up, my last question to General Purisima, was it clear that the President directed General Napenas and yourself, sir, on January 9 to coordinate with the AFP?
Even before, Your Honor, even the previous operations, there is the coordination of the AFP. That is why, Your Honor, on the anniversary of the Armed Forces of the Philippines, I brought Director Napenas to the Armed Forces of the Philippines to introduce to them on how to go about the impending operation being planned. Parang pinasilitate ko po yun, Your Honor, para makapag-usap sila kasi hindi po ako po pwedeng ako magkikipag-usap sa kanila in the first place dahil ako po ay suspendido. Kaya nga po dinala ko po siya doon para makipag-usap, makapag-touch base, makapag-coordinate, Your Honor, initially, para mapag-usapan kung ano man ang mangyayari dito po sa operation na to.
And do you not consider your statement of ako na ang bahala kay General Katapang as an amendment to that last directive of President Aquino to your group on January 9?
No, Your Honor. Ang statement ko, I really meant that ako na mag-inform kay General Katapang time on target, Your Honor.
But over and above that, you expected him, General Napenas, and the rest of the group to coordinate with the AFP based on your understanding.
That was my understanding, Your Honor.
So there was a very clear misunderstanding on that day. I will leave it at that. I will allow General Napenas to answer. Yes.
Just to clarify, Madam Chair and Your Honor, the meeting with the Chief of Staff was December 18 or 19 during the Armed Forces of the Philippines Day. The meeting with the President, the four of us, was January 9. So if such is the case, I don't think so, sir, that Ma'am, Your Honor, that in compliance to the directive of the President was done December 18, but the meeting was done in January 9, Your Honor.
Last question, lessons learned. On hindsight, if there was coordination with the AFP, would this have happened, General Napenas, since you were the commander, tactical commander?
Honestly, Your Honor, we could have done better as we have done in the past for the year 2012 and in 2014 when we were doing these operations against Abdul Basit Usman in 2012 then, because Marwan was still in Lanao del Sur. However, in our efforts to coordinate with the Armed Forces of the Philippines and they will be joining us in the operations, we were not then successful. In April of 2014, up to the May, up to the June of 2014, we were not successful in those kind of operations with due coordination and with the help from the Armed Forces of the Philippines that led us into this operation that we are going to tell them or inform them or we'll do the coordination to them at time on target, Your Honor. How I wish that we will be able to work very closely with them and get the support that we need in any type of operations that we have in the future. If I may ask, Your Honor, and with all due respect with the Armed Forces of the Philippines, the subject of our operations, Marwan, has been there since 2014. The last time that they did the operations was June 30, using the intelligence packet that we had, started in April and May. I don't know if they have known the location of Marwan in Pinsandawan from the time that they took him out in June 10 of 2014 and he transferred to Pinsandawan. I do hope that they could, I don't know if they have been doing or following it up, you know, the locations of Marwan from the time that he left in the June 10 operation somewhere in Libutan, then transferred to Pinsandawan, Your Honor. Thank you.
Thank you. Senator Legarda, just to follow up on this, General Napenas, would you like to acknowledge any possible assistance given to you by the AFP during the operation? I think that we should set this for the record.
Yes, Madam Chair, Your Honors. Contrary to the reports in the media that the AFP did not help us, we acknowledge and I would say they gave us a big help. Napakalaki po yung pagtulong nila sa amin, yung mechanized at saka yung infantry nila. Even in the rescue, yung 84th SAC in the evening, but I would like also to clarify that it is not only the Armed Forces of the Philippines who went there to rescue. That includes also our Special Action Force troopers. I would like also to acknowledge the effort of the brigade commander and the division commanders for helping us. However, I would just like to say this from the way I feel, Your Honor. Had we been given the support of artillery, which we've been asking from the very morning of that day, have we been given that they are requiring three requirements, forward observer, the coordinates and all those things, maybe we could have complied with it. Because the reason that they gave us once is there are civilians in the area, which later on in my text message, I answered, wala na po civilian doon dahil nagbabakbakan na nga at yun na rin ang feedback ng aming tao doon sa ground. Maybe if we were given the three requirements to comply, to avail of the artillery, maybe we could have done and we could have avoided this incident of losing 44 lives, Your Honor. But again, I would like to acknowledge the effort of the brigade commanders, the division commanders, and all the commanders of the Philippine Army for providing us the support that we needed during the extraction of our 84th SAC and also the mechanized brigade and the infantry that helped our 55th SAC and the 45th SAC, although they were not successful in providing the necessary support to the 55th SAC, wherein 35 of them died in that incident, Your Honor.
Thank you, General Napenas. General Napenas, binigyan ko po kayo ng pagkakataon para masabi ang katotohanan rin na may pagtulong ang military. Ngayon, lahat tayo may kakulangan dito. Kaya nga tayo nandito eh. Lahat tayo may kakulangan at humingi ng mga pribilehiyo kayo para makapag-usap tayo sa isang executive session para hindi na ito lumalapa ng pagtututuro. Sapagkat lahat naman ng datos tungkol dito ay lumalabas na. Pwede na naman kasi sabihin ng military halimbawa, katulad din ng sinasabi nila, dapat sinabihan nyo kami ng mas maaga. Wala po kaming kinakampihan dito, pero kung ganun po ang pagpapasalamat, nababawian naman po ng pagbibintang ay nawawala rin. Bumabalik po tayo dun sa ating punto na kailangan ay tumuloy-tuloy tayo sa pag-usad nito sa isang produktibong pamamaraan. Kaya ko po hiningi sa inyo for the record, sapagkat ito po ay nasa ating ay ito ay nasa ating pagsusulat kung ano ba talaga ang nagawa ng AFP. Hindi naman pwedeng wala din silang ginawa. Hindi na nga nila nilabas ang lahat ng mga nalalaman nila na maaari pang magpasama sa institusyon. Meron po ba kayong idadagdag AFP na maikli lamang na acknowledgement dito sapagkat meron nang nabitawan din si General Napenas?
Your Honor, Madam Chair, una po ako nagpapasalamat at least na-recognize nila kahit napakaliit at nabawasan yung sakit na naramdaman ko po sa ngayon. Ang hindi ko malaman po matanggap, nagpasalamat, pero just the same, we are still blamed for the death. At yun po ang masakit sa akin. Nag-uusap po tayo, marami kong isiniwalat sa inyo na hindi ko sinawalat sa una. Dahil yan po ang guidance ng aming Secretary of National Defense, ng aking Chief of Staff, ng aking Commander, na huwag nang magdagdag pa ng lalo pang ikasusugat ng mga nasaktan nating tao. Pero paano naman yung damdamin namin? Paano naman yung damdamin ng mga tao na tumulong? Yan po ang masakit sa akin. I do not want to be emotional here. Naibigay ko na po sa inyo lahat. But just the same, thank you, sir, for recognizing at least that very little effort that you think that is very little. But for me, all the efforts were given, all the efforts were done in order for you to be held in spite of the things that you done not coordinating with us. Yun lang po, Your Honor, yun lang po, Madam Chair. Maraming po salamat sa pagbibigay ng pagkakataon na masabi ko ang nilalaman ng aking dibdib at isipan. Maraming po salamat. Magandang hapon sa ating lahat.
Thank you, General Pangilinan. Madam Chair, that ends my questioning. And just to be able to summarize what General Pangilinan perhaps would have told General Napenas was, clearly you told me in the last hearing there was no forward observer. Second, there was no assessment on the position and the number of the enemy forces. Number three, there was no communication whatsoever apart from the TCP, which was in the control of the PNP SAF, and therefore you could not have fired artillery because you didn't have those three, and you didn't have also the number of the friendly forces. So with those four considerations on the ground absent, how could you therefore have fired artillery or even made your infantry effective in rescuing the remaining troops? Is that not correct, General Pangilinan?
Ma'am, the reason why we conducted the operations and inserted our infantry, it's because it is very improbable for us to fire the artillery during that time when he requested that. Kaya nga po, nagpili tayo na makapagpasok ng infantry at ng ating mechanized brigade. Muli at muli ko pong sasabihin yan. At anyway, nasabi ko na po
nasabi
sa...
Nasabi na po yan. Okay
ayaw
po
ko
yan.
Na pong
itagtag gusto ko lang yung... pong ilahad nga yung absent po ang ibang mga provision na requirement po para kayo po ay makatulong ng lubos na hindi po matamaan ang mga buhay pang SAF at ang mga civilian na nandun. Yun po ang sinasaad ko ngayon.
Opo, Your Honor. Okay. Those elements were absent during that time, Your Honors.
Thank you. Thank you, Madam Chair. Consider the head, the commander, or the person responsible for OPLAN Exodus. First, I would like to hear from the Chief of Staff of the AFP. Then I would go to the other institutions. General Katapang, please.
Madam Chair, Your Honor, really we cannot pinpoint on the part of the armed forces who is the overall commander of this operation, in as much as there's still a lot of confusion who really initiated the order to launch this. And I would rather have the PNP decide on really who was the one who decided to launch this operation.
General Purisima, would you be able to tell us now, since you told us in open hearing that this was initiated during your term when you were still active as PNP chief and met with the president when you were suspended in January of this year? May we therefore hear from you, who would you consider the head of OPLAN Exodus?
Madam Chair, Your Honor, the Philippine National Police, among the powers of the chief PNP, has the delegation of authority to sober debate. May I read the powers of the CPND, Your Honor?
You can just put that on record, sir.
Now with Senator Legarda, your 5 minutes.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Since this is, I realize, the last hearing, and all of us have sat here for 5 long sessions, apart from the executive sessions, my questions will be very, very brief and direct to the point. And I would just like to ask the heads of the various institutions present here today to just kindly answer this simple, very basic question. Who, therefore, after having heard everyone and everything, would we consider, thank you for that, could we just hear from you now, having sat here for 5 sessions, sir, in an executive session, which we don't have to discuss, but just kindly tell us, having known about Oplan Exodus from the beginning and having coordinated in a limited way after the time you were suspended, sir, who would you then consider to be the head of Oplan Exodus?
Your Honor, the responsibility, accountability of the Oplan Exodus rests with me.
Rests on?